This is Jeff Guidry for the University of Kansas Film and Media Studies. The 2007 mockumentary film, Surf's Up, by the then new kids on the block, Sony Animation Studios, hoping to be able to make a name for themselves amidst the animation giants of DreamWorks and Disney. Surf's Up was commercially unsuccessful due to shortcomings of plot, starring Shia LaBeouf as a young protagonist trying to impress a girl with the help of an older mentor and overcome his more skilled adversary. Not the most original narrative. The animation style is fairly realistic compared to actual footage of penguins, comparable aesthetics to that of other cartoon penguin films of the time. But Sony here set itself apart by adding another layer through parody of other surf documentaries. Being the first and only animated mockumentary, the animators create archival footage that mirrors old travelettes. By matching the digital frame movement, the classic surf filmmaker's camera movement, it simulates the realism of the animated penguins. The first time the audience gets to see the protagonist surfing is at night, with a low light source mimicking perhaps the most famous cinematography of any surf film, that of Bruce Brown in The Endless Summer. Here there is a montage of wipeouts, also featured in The Endless Summer. Even the use of the indigenous penguins for comic effect parallels Brown's use of the locals in Lagos, Nigeria, and his tongue-in-cheek racism. And even if the audience member isn't familiar with surf at all, this reproduction of surf films helps to create the aura of realism beyond the CGI. And even to those who aren't interested in surf films, it is recognizable. Sports Network used in the film likely draws in a personal connection with more of the audience and grounds the plot in a realistic sounding competition because it's based off of real surf competitions. Even the commentators are just cameos of 11-time World Surf League champion Kelly Slater and goofy footer laid-back Rob Cotto. The film also utilizes still images, much like director Ken Burns does in his many popular documentary series. Finally, the directors Ash Brandon and Chris Buck play themselves in the movie as the voices behind the camera and can have the artificial camera interact with its virtual surrounding, engaging the audience in ways no other animated film can really do. It allows you to feel as if you're seeing these fictitious characters caught off guard, giving greater insight into their character. Sony didn't view the film as a success, grossing only $58 million, and soon moved away from the concept in favor of more profitable films. But seeing as the film's critical success, and the only of Sony's animated films to be nominated for an Academy Award, this mockumentary style deserves to be looked at for future guidance.